Hello everyone, Michael here with the Daily Note 2 and 3 YouTube channel, and today is all about S Note for the Galaxy Note 3. So the big question has been, are all the functions of S Note on the Galaxy Note 2, are they present on the Galaxy Note 3? Yes, but a couple of functions on the Galaxy Note 2's S Note have moved away from the S Note app. So let me give you an example. The Galaxy Note 2's S Note used to be the pop-up note reader. Well, all the pop-up note functionality, it is now called Action Memo. It has been moved away from the S Note app, and you do it all inside the Action Memo app, right? So this has been completely separated from anything related to S Note. You manage all your notes in there, and it accesses the files really quickly, so it makes a big difference. And another thing that has been moved away from the S Note, you used to be able to long tap on this shape icon called productivity tools and then click on the function icon, function button there. Then you used to be able to do this. And then you could do search. And then it used to open up Wolfram Alpha, and then it used to do that math equation for you. Well, that does not happen on the S Note anymore. So you can do this on the Galaxy Note 3, but it is just really buried in there, and I'm not kidding. Just open up Air Command, go to S Finder. On the search field, hover over the cursor. You'll see that pen icon. Just click into that, click on the function there, and now you can do this. And you could go to search. And there you go, Wolfram Alpha. Now that really took some time to find for you guys. Other than the Wolfram Alpha thing, everything else has been pretty nice. So let's look at S Note. So you could see it came with this big large widget when I first got my Note 3. So let's tap into that. Same thing as clicking on the icon there, but it comes with this nice video intro. And here you could just select a couple of cover styles that you would like to use later, preferably. Sure. And I would recommend just picking the blank canvas here, because a lot of these are nice because, you know, they are styled and you could just tap into it, add a picture, but it's not going to be useful for everything new that you write. And you're selecting the default template for everything new that you create. So yeah, white makes sense. You could see that you could sync the S notes that you create into Samsung account or Evernote. So I'll just select Evernote, but it probably works the same. So one thing that I really like the Galaxy Note 3 is the eraser function. So let me write my name. And if you want to erase it, it's really quick. Just go through it and it just gets rid of the strokes. So I spent a lot of time with S Note today, and I could say for certain that all the functions that you had on the Galaxy Note 2's S Note is indeed in here. So let me just go over the ones that you might be looking for that are a little bit hard to find. So for example, you wanna make this into a perfect square, and you wanna make this into a perfect circle. Well, you need to first select it. So I'm going to select, and then I'm going to transform info, and then I'm going to do shape. Same thing for here, I'll select it. Transform info, shape, and now there are perfect squares and circles, or I guess that's a rectangle. So let me show you a hidden gesture on the S Note. So hover over this icon on the bottom left and you see that it's kind of glowing. Just click with your clicker on the S Pen, and now you can select pictures out of your gallery. And just in case you haven't seen this, I thought it was a cool effect. This is present on the Galaxy Note 2, but you could add effects to the image that you add to your S Note, and I thought that looked cool, so I just want to show you that. Okay, moving on. Here's another one. Say that you want to rotate some text. And select the selector tool, but you can't put a box around it. You need to do a long tap because it is a object, and you can move this. And with here, you can rotate it. So let's look in here, and I'll only talk about what's new on the S Note for the Note 3. So Easy Chart is a new thing. So let's create a pie chart. You can draw a pie in here, and then you could select slices. Then you could give these names, and you could change the name from item one to something like pizza. And then say you want to adjust this, you want to change this to 17%, 17.1, and it took that. So yeah, it's pretty cool. Let's resize this a little bit. Every other functionality other than maybe scrapbook is inside your Galaxy Note 2. And you could see all the stuff that I've been playing with the scrapbooking tool from this, right? Just scrapbook something, it ends up in there, and now I can place it into the S Note. And from the menu button here, you can record your sketching. So I'm going to hit that record button and draw a couple of squiggly lines. Then I'm going to hit this check mark to save it, and to play back your recording you have this icon here. And another thing that you'll be able to see is if you did a voice recording, there'll be a similar type of icon there. Oh, and one last thing, there's this gesture here. So say that you're drawing and you want to get rid of these tools here, with your three fingers you could just spread out. And supposedly you could bring it in by doing that reverse motion. So I've exited out of my S Note app, and you could see the widget now shows a couple of things here. Okay, so you could see the recent notes here. There's a preview. You could flip through different notebooks that you created. And inside the S Note app directly, you could do this. You could drag the S Note down and you could get a preview of what's inside by dragging it down. And one last thing, remember we synced this with Evernote. So go inside your Evernote app, and now you could see that it has the note that we created, and it just kind of ends up in there. So anyway, that's the end of today's episode, and make sure you check out my other videos on the Galaxy Note 2 and 3 in my YouTube channel, and make sure you subscribe for more upcoming videos. Once again, thank you for watching.